Uncertainty calculations. Let's talk about this real quick. To calculate uncertainty of a measurement, the point of this is to get a feel for how confident you are in your measurement. So it's a pretty simple equation. Uncertainty equals precision of the measurement, and we'll talk about that next, divided by the measured value, or the mean if you measured something multiple times. I will start. Looking at your data, the stopwatch measures to the tenth of a second. So if you look here, 2.4, the precision is to the tenth, or 0.1. 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. Every single measurement is presented to the tenth. So in this case, the precision of all these measurements are to the tenth. And so when we go on to our next slide, that's what we'll use in the equation for uncertainty. We'll put 0.1 on top. Help you calculate the uncertainty of this first column, 2.4, 2.3, 2.4, 2.1, and 2.4. So hopefully you remember how to calculate the mean. You add these up. So you go 2.4 plus 2.3 plus 2.4 plus 2.1 plus 2.4. So you get the sum, and then you divide by the number of samples, and there's 5. So you sum these up, divide by 5. And let's take a quick peek. Let's see, I got 2.3 for my mean when you do all that work. We're just going to round to the tenth in this case. And so to calculate the uncertainty, we need to take the precision of the measurement, divide it by the mean, multiply it by 100 to make it a percent. So we've already discussed this. The precision is 0.1. The mean, when you calculate it, is 2.3 seconds. And so all we have to do is put that in your calculator, multiply by 100, and go ahead and do that. If you want to pause the video, you can. But what I got was 4.3%. So what that's saying is my times, when I measured 1 meter, my uncertainty of that measurement is 4.3%. That's not bad. If you were sending someone to the moon, 4.3% wouldn't be good. You want to hit a bullseye. So, but for in our class, the day-to-day measurements that we make, 4.3% is pretty good. So what I'd like you guys to do is repeat this for 2 meters up here and 3 meters up here. So again, you're going to add them up, divide by 5 to get the mean. And then you'll do the exact same thing here. It'll be 0.1 seconds divided by the new mean. So this one will be closer to 4. And the time for 3 meters, it looks like it'll be closer to 6. All right, good luck. Okay. Let's look at this question. Write a brief explanation, write a summary explaining the trend in uncertainty values for 1, 2, and 3 meters. So if you look at this equation, well, first off, you can just look at your answers. But what you'll see is that the mean value went up, and if the denominator in a fraction goes up, the uncertainty goes down. So that's going to be important in all our labs. We want to decrease our uncertainty of measurements. So anytime you have a chance to make the measured value bigger, like for example, if you want to know the mass of 1 penny, you might as well mass 10 pennies, or better yet, 100 pennies, as much as that scale can handle, and that'll help decrease your uncertainty. Okay, let's take a look at number 2. Explain how you decrease the uncertainty, or how you could decrease the uncertainty of the measurements above. And so, if you look at this equation, the uncertainty is precision divided by the mean. The mean was beyond your control. You couldn't change that. That was just the numbers you calculated. So what's left is the precision. So in the math terms, in the numerator, you want this number to decrease uncertainty. But let's take a look at what that means over here. What does that mean to decrease precision? Well, it's almost better to say you want to increase precision to decrease this value. So if instead of being accurate to the tenth, what if you're accurate to the hundredth, 2.31, then the precision would be 0.01. So instead of having 0.1 at the top, you'd have 0.01. And even more accurate, what if you had a stopwatch accurate to the thousandth of a second? Then you put 0.001 here. So how would you decrease the uncertainty of the measurements above? You would actually increase precision. But again, what that means is you decrease this value. Okay. So the trick to this, though, is it costs money. If you have a stopwatch that measures to the tenth, and then all of a sudden you have a fancy timer that measures to the hundredth or even to the thousandth of a second, it costs more money. So typically, in our public schools here at Gunnison High School, we don't have much choice over the precision. We do the best we can, but what we can do is increase measured value. So in summary, we'll be asking you this in the future in the form of a quiz. What are the two ways that you can decrease the uncertainty of a measurement? So A, you can increase the measured value and have a more precise measurement, which makes this top number smaller.